Welcome to another edition of Ask Game Dev's Game Engine Showcases. Today's feature is actually a framework. That's right, today we're showing off our favorite games made with LibGDX. LibGDX is a free and open source cross-platform Java game development framework. With LibGDX, you can write both 2D and 3D games and export to platforms including iOS, Android, Linux, Mac, Windows, and more. In terms of features, LibGDX includes support for audio, input handling, math and physics, graphics, service integration, file I/O and storage, and networking. Take a look at their features page to learn more. Without further ado, we are Ask Game Dev, and these are the best games made with LibGDX. Welcome back. We make videos on how to elevate your game development and inspire others. If after watching this video, you want to continue the game dev conversation, check out the video description for a link to our Discord server. We are now making fresh Ask Game Dev content on all of the major social networks, so be sure to check us out there too. First up on the list is Delver, by devs Chad Cudigan and Joshua Skelton, who make up Priority Interrupt. Delver is a first-person roguelike dungeon crawler with RPG elements. In the game, you delve into ever-changing procedural dungeons in your search for the powerful Yathidian orb. What caught our attention first with Delver was its Cartoon Network-esque key art. Once we took a look at the game, though, it was no surprise to us that the actual game art was even better. The title features a unique art style that places flat 2D pixel art characters and objects into 3D worlds with pixel art textures. The results look amazing. The character designs are charming, and their reactive animations really bring the world of Delver to life. The title was released in 2018, and as of today, it sits at a very positive rating on Steam with over 2,000 reviews. We love that years after release, the devs are still actively maintaining the title. But here's why we wanted to put Delver first on the list. In November 2018, the same year that the title was released, the devs open-sourced the tech behind Delver for public use. This was an amazing and well-appreciated move for the game development community. You can check out the Delver engine on GitHub. It's licensed under the GNU General Public License v2.0, meaning the Delver engine can be shared, edited, distributed for free, and also be used for commercial purposes. Check the description for links to Delver and the Delver engine. If you're a fan of games like Don't Starve and Crashlands and you love cats, number two on our list will be right up your alley. Moonbase, by solo developer Steve Ford, aka Karen Four. Moonbase is a top-down 2D survival base-building game that stars a lovable space cat. The premise is simple. You land in an uncharted world with your trusty workbench and just enough to survive, and you start building your base. Explore the unknown, find food, collect resources, and craft your way to survival. Maintain your space cat's oxygen, power, and hunger levels, all while expanding your base, crafting new items, and unlocking tech upgrades. The title has been praised for being a relaxing base-building game. To paraphrase what a reviewer said,
"Sometimes you just want to chill out and build a base. You don't want to have to be worried about someone or something coming to attack you."
Moonbase has been in development since 2016 and is currently available as an early access title. As of this writing, V0.52 is currently in development. If you'd like to see how development is going, the dev actually keeps a public Trello board. Not only is this great viewing for the Moonbase community, but it's also great to see how devs plan and organize. We'll make sure to leave a link to the board in the description. Next up on the list is Pathway, by Robotality. Pathway is a squad-based, turn-based tactics adventure that takes place in the 1930s Great Wilderness. Think a pixel-perfect version of The Mummy or Indiana Jones meets XCOM. It also features a branching, choose-your-own-adventure method of storytelling complete with over 400 story events. Build your team from the game's 16 unlockable, unique, bold adventurers and journey through bunkers and temples of Northern Africa. raid tombs, outwit enemies, discover rare weapons and hidden treasures, and unravel mysteries of the occult. Robotality, a team of four based in Hameln, Germany, started working on Pathway in 2014. The title took just over 4 years to develop and was released on Steam in April of 2019. As of this writing, the title has a mostly positive rating on Steam with over 1,400 reviews. At launch, Kotaku called the title
an Indiana Jones-inspired tactics game that's hard to put down. Good strategy RPGs are rare these days, and rarer still are ones that weave together so many disparate elements as effectively as Pathway does,
reads the article. The team uses LibGDX, as well as a base framework with their own render pipeline on top. For another awesome example of a game made with LibGDX, check out their previous title, Halfway. You can get both titles and save a bit by buying the Robotality bundle on Steam. For number 4 on the list, let's take a look at a mobile classic, Gunslugs, by solo dev OrangePixel, aka Pascal. Gunslugs is a run-and-gun side-scroller that reminds us of games like Contra and Metal Slug. It's the perfect mobile title for anyone looking for some pick-up-and-play action, and with its randomly generated levels, it offers a ton of replayability. The reason OrangePixel is on the list, though, isn't because of Gunslugs alone, but because of an entire library of awesome retro-inspired games and amazing game dev content. Let's look at more OrangePixel first. Just to name a few, there's Meganoid, described as a Spelunky and Meat Boy love child in space. Gunslugs 3, Rogue Tactics, a hybrid that features platforming, stealth, and tactical decision-making. Space Grunts 2, a 1950s sci-fi roguelike that features turn-based gameplay and card-battling mechanics. Heroes of Loot, an award-winning dungeon crawler that sold more than 500,000 units. Snake Core, OrangePixel's spin on the classic Snake game. And Residual, an upcoming survival title. And did we mention great game dev content? OrangePixel makes weekly game dev content on YouTube. In his videos, he features dev stories, shares resources, shows his source code, recommends game dev tools, and more. Make sure to check out the OrangePixel YouTube channel. We recommend watching What is the Best Game Engine for Your Game? We'll have a link in the description. At number 5 on the list, we have the spaceship colony simulation game, Spacehaven, by Bugbyte Limited. The newest title on this list, Spacehaven launched into early access in May of 2020. In under a year, the title has achieved great success and has already managed to receive over 3,500 Steam reviews, where it sits with a very positive rating. In Spacehaven, you're on a voyage with your ragtag crew of civilians. Earth is burning, and you and your crew are part of the privileged few able to search for a new home world. Build your spaceship tile by tile, create optimal gas conditions, manage your crew, prepare for encounters, and explore the universe. Inspired by games like RimWorld, Space-Base DF9, and Oxygen Not Included, Spacehaven combines the emergent narrative features of RimWorld with the gas simulation system of Oxygen Not Included. Finland-based Bugbyte have been making games together for 8 years. Their previous titles include Battle Void Harbinger and Battle Void Sector Siege. Prior to releasing Battle Void Harbinger in late 2015, the studio was on the verge of bankruptcy. Luckily, Harbinger was a hit, and they've continued to pump out amazing work. As of this video, Spacehaven has been in development for 5 years. The penultimate game on the list combines two of our favorite genres, Mindustry by Anuke. Mindustry combines base building and tower defense to create a tower defense sandbox factory hybrid experience. Factory sims are fun in their own right, and so are tower defense titles. Mindustry bridges the gap and has created a genre that's greater than the sum of its parts. In Mindustry, you create elaborate supply chains of conveyor belts to feed ammo into your turrets, produce materials to use for building, and defend your structures from waves of enemies. Earlier in this list, we praised Priority Interrupt for making the tech behind Delver open source and opening it up for public use. We also loved how the Trello board for Munebase was publicly available to view. Well, Anuke has you covered for Mindustry as well. Not only is the Mindustry Trello board available to view, but the entire source code of Mindustry is up on GitHub. Mindustry is available on Steam, iOS, and Android. It's also available, as mentioned earlier, on GitHub and on itch.io, where it's available via a name your price model, though the dev says to consider buying the game on Steam for features like achievements, seamless multiplayer, and map browsing slash workshop support. As one of the most popular titles on this list, Mindustry currently sits at an overwhelmingly positive rating on Steam, with almost 7,000 reviews. Before we look at the final title on our list of the best games made with libgdx, let's take a look at a couple of honorable mentions. Our first honorable mention is Transfinite Dungeon by Icefill. From the makers of SFD, Rogue TRPG, Transfinite Dungeon is an upcoming tactical RPG and roguelike hybrid. While the title is still in development, you can check out Transfinite Dungeon's Steam page for links to a demo and Discord server, and of course, to add it to your wishlist. The next honorable mention on our list is not a game at all, but a powerful 2D animation tool. Spine by Esoteric Software. Spine's 2D skeletal animation allows devs to create fluid character animations faster and more efficiently. In addition to that, the Spine mesh system creates very convincing 3D looks using only 2D assets. Games that use Spine for their animations include Rise and Shine, Unruly Heroes, and Wolverblade. And finally, the most popular game on our list, the indie hit Slay the Spire by Megacrit Games. Slay the Spire is a roguelike deck-building dungeon crawler. As we mentioned in our Best Game Engines for Nintendo Switch video, in Slay the Spire, you play as one of three heroes, each with their own unique card pools, and you work your way through a gauntlet of monsters, earning new cards to help you advance. The design was inspired by the idea of fusing two genres together. As a lifelong card game player and fan of roguelikes, Anthony Giovanetti, who led the design effort and did the programming, thought that the deck-building genre and the roguelike genre would have a particularly strong mechanical pairing, and he was right. The title launched as an early access title in 2017, and 1 year later, the game had more than 500,000 players. At GDC 2019, co-founder Casey Yano announced that the title had tripled that number, selling more than 1.5 million copies across all its platforms. By 2020, Slay the Spire had made Rock Paper Shotgun's Best PC Games of 2020 list. And the praise doesn't stop there, with Rock Paper Shotgun calling it the best news of 2021 so far. It was recently announced that there will be a Slay the Spire board game. Thanks for watching. For more Ask Game Dev, check out this video on solo game development or this playlist of more game engine showcases.